Today was the first meeting for the South Florida Water Management District since Governor Ron DeSantis called for the resignation of all the old board members.
A simmering feud between outgoing water managers and the governor ended with a bunch of no-shows and the executive director's resignation, crippling the board's ability to get anything done. NBC2's Jacqueline Beavis traveled to West Palm Beach to find out what's ahead for our water.
It has been the complete privilege of my life at this point to serve the 20 months that I've had the opportunity to serve.
Emotions running high as board members who chose to resign and those completing their term offer advice to incoming leaders.
Be more enamored with the solution than you are with a theory. That is what our stakeholders deserve.
Keep the politics, the politicians, and the paid special interest groups out.
Support came from members of the public, thanking the men at the front of the room.
I just want to thank the board for all your dedication.
It is a tremendous balancing act.
Learning also that the executive director of the district will be new as well.
My time has passed, and I wish my successors the best of luck.
Empty seats taking their share of the attention today without enough board members to vote on any decision.
But because we didn't have a quorum, we couldn't do it, so that's another delay.
Recently appointed member Chauncey Goss tells me he's waiting on completion of paperwork for his swearing in before he can report to his seat.
I'm really looking forward to having representation from all around the state and for all of us, because I don't believe that that's been happening.
Representatives from Sanibel, like Holly Smith, hopeful that the future of the board keeps water a top priority.
C-43 was on the agenda, and that's a huge project, so we were really, really excited to see that in front of us.
The current leader is ending on a high note.
I see a very bright future for South Florida.
And a standing ovation. The items like the C-43 reservoir project are expected to be added to the March agenda to be discussed then. Between now and then, Governor Ron DeSantis is expected to appoint several new board members for those empty seats. Reporting in West Palm Beach, Jacqueline Beavis, NBC2.
All new, tonight at 7.